Greetings. I am a Dragon Alchemist, and allow me to entertain you. I am once again playing Fallout 4, Nuka-World, and I'm here with this Novatron Eliminator. Still wondering whether it was any good hacking into the thing, considering it's not really all that useful. I've barely even seen this thing try and attack anything that has been hostile to me. But I'll keep it around. It's interesting looking, to say the least. And maybe, just maybe, it'll use that eye laser to some actual good. As long as it stops staring at me. When something has eye lasers, you don't want it to stare at you like that. Especially with an armed like that. But anyways, we're here, still at the Galactic Zone, and I'm still looking for the Star Cores. Stop looking at me. Now, I noticed that there was this door here that I had yet to open, so let's, 5 of 6. One more Star Core to find. Now, I'd love to take this Fusion Core, but unfortunately, I'm kind of overladen, so that's gonna have to be left behind. Stop pushing me. I swear, that's another reason why I should just shut you down. Now let's take that control room key, and I'm guessing this is another terminal where... Yeah, Vault-Tec here has been experimenting on the park visitors, because they're Vault-Tec. Project Consumer Guidance. What does this have to say?
This is Luis Bateman reporting on week 2 of Project Consumer Guidance. Civilian employees are starting to experience extreme headaches similar to the previous study. Luckily, the associated depression has not surfaced, so suicides aren't expected to be an issue yet. The increase in subliminal messaging frequency continues to have little to no effect on many visitors. But the speed at which the park staff was affected does show that some level of success has been achieved. I recommend moving forward with the audio tours for the next project. Perhaps a higher frequency of messaging fed directly into a consumer who can focus will be more effective.
I'm guessing the skeleton here is Lewis Bateman, the project lead for this cheery little endeavor. And it sounds like they weren't just researching the visitors, they were actually performing tests on the park staff as well. So yeah, the guy that was paranoid that he's also being tested on? Dead on right. And simply dead, unfortunately. So let's see what's in the Project Lead Terminal. Experiment 1. Experiment 1. It's brainwave disruption. Use of radiation scrubbers in exhibit to emit an electrical field that causes interference in the brainwave patterns of human subjects. Expected results. Minor loss of motor control, temporary stupor, and forgetfulness. And like an idiot, I walked through that one when I walked in. Experiment number 2, subliminal suggestions. Use of audio emitters to generate varying degrees of subliminal suggestions overlaid with a specific frequency. Expected results. Acceptance of suggestions causing subjects to perform involuntary actions. Headaches, depression, or minor other phenomena resulting from neurochemical release. And it sounds like I wandered into that one as well. No subliminal suggestions, but the headaches certainly were there. Experiment 3. Hypnotic pheromones. Use of genetic modification of flora to release a pheromone-like airborne toxin, which will be inhaled while passing by the emitters. Expected results, loss of an independent thought, minor addiction, susceptibility to suggestion. Where did my tongue go there? Well, fortunately for me, I'm wearing a gas mask. And I'm also wearing power armor, which has air filtration, so that should work out for me. Experiment 4, theta radiation. Oh yeah, I got a good dose of that. Use of reactor modifications to emit theta band radiation in low, short doses. Expected results? Drowsiness, extreme fatigue, potential paranoia from sleep deprivation. Yeah, there goes that guy that had that happen to him. Experiment number 5. Long-term testing. Use of experiments 0 through 4 on Hodgson, Grunner, Dallas, Bartleby, and Langston to assess long-term effects. Expected results varies by experiments. So yeah, testing of both visitors and the staff.
Step into your spacious
Lovely to know that the corporations of the old world were constantly screwing one another.
Oh shit. Rad's here, boss. And be honest, you're clear.
Yeah, I noticed.
You can rest assured that your colony will have enjoy a rich.
Oh. Holy! Duck!
Hey, eyes up.
Yeah, I noticed. Holy!
Sir?
Oh, wrong button, I was trying to toss a grenade. Too late now. Well, not too late.
Kill.
Enjoy! It didn't damage it? Dinah must have gotten right around the corner. Okay, now enjoy!
Warning.
Whoa, where did that grenade bounce go? There we go, much better. Take the ammunition, and not much else, because I can't carry much more. Let's grab that turret.
You're gonna regret this.
Okay, and yep, grenade got the other turret that was shooting from up above. Let's avoid the sprinkler system to the right. Let's reload two. Ah, more stuff that I could potentially eat.
Sir?
But I'm not all that thrilled about the idea of eating contaminated fruit.
And with Vault-Tec's cutting-edge science and technology, you can rest assured that your colony will have the resources to face any challenge.
Okay, we're about this way.
New adventure awaits. Imagine hundreds of colonies spread throughout the galaxy
Sir?
And beyond.
Yeah, just making sure we don't wander into more turrets. This thing is pushing me again. Alright, let's see what's in here. Anything interesting? Ah! Body of a traitor. With some goodies! Ah!
Sir?
Caring too much again. What do I need to drop? What am I rolling with now? I could drop 4 grenades to get me underweight. Could drop the revolver, potentially. See here. The laser's a little heavier, but costs the same, so I'll drop that instead.
Imagine a future.
What was that?
Imagine a future among the stars. Imagine Vault-Tec.
Sir?
Imagine a future without Vault-Tec. Now, I'm
for
not
exactly. Or to sign up for the Vault program, please see a sales associate. Thank you, and enjoy your day here at Nuka-World.
Now, I was about to say,
Sir?
Whether Vault-Tec should have existed or not, it's a hard call. Because without Vault-Tec, that means no vaults, and as sick and twisted as Vault-Tec was, people actually survived down there in the vaults. Without Vault-Tec, a lot more people would have been on the surface when things went bad, and, well, that means potentially a lot more casualties. But at the same time, that also meant that a lot of people got experimented upon. So they could have saved a lot more people, but at the same time, they killed a lot of people. Did they potentially save more people than got killed? Hard call, but I'd say yes.
What could go wrong?
Because without the vaults, no safety. They'd be up on the surface and they'd have to fend for themselves. A small minority would have been comfortable in the vaults, like the one at Vault 114. They had the very, very rare happy circumstance of having an overseer that had a conscience. Can't say the same for the rest, but because of that, others did survive. People did survive. And those people may very well have gotten killed otherwise. Now let's see about sales instructions. Hello, Vault-Tec sales associate. As people exit the Vault-Tec Among the Stars exhibit, you'll be responsible for taking visitors aside and converting them to potential applicants. Even if they seem interested, remember that the applicant will have many questions but very little time on their hands. How can you ensure you're prepared to step them through our sales process in a quick and accurate manner? Simple. Remember the three I's. Introduction, initiation, and information. No, if any applicants appear to be ill or acting in a strange manner, please be certain to report this to a sales supervisor immediately. Oops, accidentally exited. Alright. Step 1, introduction. First and foremost, greet the applicant with a hearty handshake and a warm smile. Perhaps a light, clean joke to make them laugh, or a pleasant compliment about their appearance. Ask them if they want something to drink or offer them a snack. Check how they're feeling and gauge their mood. Make them feel like they're already home and a part of the Vault-Tec family. Studies show, beginning with this approach increases the chances of a sale by over 28%. Initiation. When you feel like you've gained their confidence, explain the benefits of life within a vault using the information from our Better Living Underground packet. If they still appear hesitant, don't pester them or give them the hard sell. Our studies show that this over-aggressive approach usually turns the applicants off, and they become unwilling to listen to anything you have to say. For the overly skeptical applicant, or if you need something to tip the scales if you think the applicant is undecided, we suggest letting them glance through the history of radiation burns or the mutations it could happen to you brochures. Step 3, integration. So, you finally convinced the applicant to sign. Good job! Now it's time to step them through the quick and painless application process. Pull the following forms from the new applications file. G708-9 health form, TR17 liability waiver, LM222 last will and testament form, DB104 Vault-Tec citizen agreement, XM003 organ donation invoice, HW660 psychological evaluation screening, KY269 intimate relations contact agreement, PLK575 rights reclamation charter, and the FQS010 family history form. Have the applicant fill these out in quintuplicate. File the daffodil color copy in the corporate bin, file the lemon color copy in the local bin, place the canary colored copy in the medical bin, place the gold colored copy in the insurance bin, and present the yellow full copy to the applicant. Do not place the wrong copy in the wrong bins or the process will have to be repeated. I swear that the Vault-Tec guys were screwing with their own employees just as much as everyone else. Canary, gold, daffodil. Yeah, they were certainly screwing with them. Alright, where is this last star core? I'm gonna have to go back, see if I missed anything. I don't think I checked down here, did I? Alright, just make sure. Okay. Nope, not this way. Ah, come on. Get out of my way. Get out of my way. Out. Thank you. Alright. Where is this last star core? Oh. It was right there. Figures. Alright, we can leave now. We can leave. We're gonna head back to the star control, place the cores in, and then afterwards, we're gonna head back to the Fizztop Grill. Offload all the junk, sell everything else up for caps, and then come back and do another scavenger hunt.
Sir?
Maybe leave this thing behind at the grill. Right, so far so good. Unfortunately, the stuff is wearing off slowly. That's good news. Bad news, it's still affecting me a little bit. First things first, let's get something to eat and drink. I got some vegetable soup and noodles to give myself a little pick-me-up. Properly fed, properly hydrated. Now, Star Control was this way, if I recall. Just gotta go up the ramp. Well, actually not go up the ramp, because going up the ramp would go to the second story. The Star Control is actually on the first story. Here we are. How am I gonna get into you? Probably gotta find all the cores. Gotta get this scavenger hunt done for a big honkin' reward. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6. That's all the star cores I have on me.
Sir?
Not enough for more applications, I think. I don't think that was enough for anything new. Oh, no, no, no. There's emergency shutdown number 2. Let's see. Sultron, Patektrons, Handies, Turrets. Let's shut down the turrets. There's practically no way I can hack into them. Alright. Shutdown of turrets is successful. Yeah, because if I try to hack into a turret, it's gonna make mincemeat out of me. Charbroiled mincemeat at that.
Sir?
Those things would react way too fast and I wouldn't be able to hack in, so... And they're normally out of reach. Can't get up to them, can't hack into them, so I have to shut them down remotely. Huh. I missed losing you.
All
right. My mistake. Some vodka, some frothy. Alright, time to head back to Fizz Top, pack everything in, and head back out to do it all again. Such is the life of the overboss. As was sarcastically mentioned earlier, don't I have minions for this sort of thing? Well, well, well. This was expected. Came to the market to offload all my stuff, and guess what? There's a Star Core right here for the taking. That's 1 of 5 outside the Galactic Zone.
Sure.
Gotta wonder where the rest of the 5 are.
For a second.
But that's gonna be a scavenger hunt of epic proportions. Unless I so happen to check my map and maybe, just maybe, there are some hints outside. Please tell me there are. Please tell me there are. Otherwise, this is gonna be. Yep, it's gonna be way too easy if they just gave it to me like that, wouldn't it? Well. Fair enough. At least I got one of the 5 outside. Got no promises about finding the 5 others, but I'll try. Now to head back to Fizztop Grill. Get some sleep. Alright, got back to Galactic Zone, and we're gonna keep on going with the original theme, working this place from left to right. So let's see if I missed anything before when I got here. Don't think I did. Yeah, looks pretty clear to me right here, so we're good. Gonna keep on working the left side, though. Going to keep working the left side. Now, that entails going down, I guess. Gotta go through the employee area. Now, this place... It would've been rather nice if not for the whole sugar theme... The soft drinks. Then again, what kind of theme would have replaced this thing? I don't really know what would have worked. I guess I really gotta work way to the right then, unless I go upstairs. Yeah, I mean just in general. Stars, galaxy, sci-fi theme? Yeah, that would have worked on its own. Why bother with all the Nuka stuff? But it's a corporation! Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Hey, hey. Oh, come on. I hate it when that shot cancels. Thank you. Well, it's abundantly clear that I've yet to clear out everything here. Come on. Oh, come on! That was on target! Guess I wasn't leading my shots enough. Gage? Porter? What are you doing? Why are you running in the middle of that? How in the world am I missing? How am I missing easy shots like this? And why am I getting weird visual glitches like this? I should have just pitched a grenade down there. Would have made things so much easier. You okay down there, Porter? I'm guessing the answer's no. If you like irradiated junk piles, go on ahead. Well, glad I got up here at least. Gave me a good Overwatch position for Porter. Don't know why he charged in there on his own, but hey.
Fugitive is attempting to evade capture. Beginning pursuit.
Can he jump through? Okay, good, I can jump through. Let's clear the top section of this scaffolding. Maybe whatever it is
Warning.
Is up here.
Dangerous fugitive is on the loose. Do not attempt to apprehend.
What is this, really? Is this a ride? Oh, this is one of those rides, huh? Alright, fair enough. Ah, Star Court.
Search for fugitive.
Well, that's one ride down, but where are the rest? You know what? Reload. Don't hold the shot, because I got no idea where I'm shooting. Maybe it's at the bottom of the stairs?
Attention. Fugitive should be considered armed and dangerous.
Guess I can't recall whatever was up there.
Hostile has escaped. Transmitting description to designated law enforcement authorities. Intruder.
Oh. A little quicker on the draw than you. Yeah, send my description to them. I'm sure they'll congratulate me by putting my face on a wanted poster. Wait, what? Nuka Galaxy? Oh. Well, I guess I can walk into there. Yeah, you're shut down, that's good. Another traitor. That should mean there might be some more stuff behind him. Oh, Star Core, excellent. Nuka Grape, I always want to find more of that stuff. Dirty water, take it. Alright, who's firing out there? Porter, is that you? Or is that somebody else? If it's someone else, I'm not sure I'm going to be able to get out there, considering all the walls around here. Yeah, I don't think my jetpack's going to allow me to climb up all that way. Well, maybe. I'm going to have to check, but I doubt it. Let's see, take this, be a little more circumspect about what I grab. Yeah, whatever is firing out there, it sounds like a sustained firefight. Don't know if I'm going to be able to reach up all the way over here to see what it is, but I'm going to try. Jump! And... Oh, whoa. Alright, I actually got up top here. Doesn't really tell me what I'm looking at, though. Jump up. Okay, got to the roof. I'm not sure if I was supposed to be up here, but let's see what we're looking at. Okay, where's the gunfire? I hear a lot of gunfire, but I don't see anyone. No muzzle flashes, no sparks. Where is this? Am I just out of the zone? Alright, I'm jumping down. Oh! Super mutants! I jumped into a bunch of super mutants! That was one of the stupidest ideas I could have done. But I didn't see anything. Go down! Switch out! Well, good to know that I got some backup here. Okay, running back out. Because I need to reload. Okay. Okay. Don't hit the disciples. Disciples are friendly. Disciples also have a minigun. Whew. Okay. Well, this was not on the plan today, but thanks for the assist.
Hey there.
It's about time someone with half a brain ran this show. Just don't mess it up.
Okay. That, that could have gotten better, but hey, we managed to take this place over. Ooh, a safe. That was easy.
That's it.
That was way too easy.
I'm a fan of antiques, boss.
Depends on the nature of the antique. If the disciples weren't in here, Wow, texture glitching. I would have just pitched a grenade in here and called it a day. But, oh well. They had a minigun, they dealt with the situation. What was this place? Is this a little supply side depot or something? Electrical substation? Let's keep looking around, Take anything of worth, leave the rest behind. Oh, okay. That's a disciple. Dragging a cardboard box between our legs. Don't know why, but I'm not gonna question it. Yep, she's dragging a cardboard box. That's exactly what she's doing. Check for traps. Good. Ooh, med supplies, thank you. Ooh, duct tape, thank you very much. Oil, yes, please. I'll leave that for the disciples. They came to raid this place. They can have whatever I don't take. I'm the overbox, so I get first pickings after all.
Yes.
Pastor's vestments. I can understand the mechanic jumpsuit concerning the place, but was someone a pastor here? Why would they need a pastor at an amusement park? Was there some exorcism craziness going on? Oh no, this guy's twitching and speaking in tongues, writhing on the ground! We need a priest!
Nice.
Or we possibly need a doctor because someone's having a sugar high. One of the two! Bring both! Can't hurt. Okay, so I jumped out of the park because I heard a lot of gunfire. Wild mute fruit. Nah, no thanks. I mean, not one of my smartest ideas, but it could have been someone that really needed the help. Well, technically the disciples did need my help, but it's not exactly like they're a group that I want to help, necessarily. In fact, all the raider groups are a group I don't necessarily want to help. Oh, I must have missed this entrance. Well, good that I came this way at least. That's a lot of good stuff on that Assaultron. Caps. Ooh, Tarberry. Tarberries are one of those things, the few things that don't carry radiation. So, they're one of the good things I want to pick up. Alright, Porter, you know what time it is.
More than happy to hold all the expensive stuff.
And good that I shut down that turret control, because guess what's right behind him?
The entrance to the Stampede Carousel.
I loved carousels when I was growing up. Still kind of do, really. Oh, that's leading a dry rock gulch. Not going there yet. Not going there yet. Any star cores that anyone else smuggled out? Okay.
Attention guests. If you've lost your hidden cappy glasses, additional pairs can be purchased from any souvenir stand in any of our parks.
Souvenir stands. Good to know, but I still got the cappy glasses. Don't know when I'm gonna get around to actually start searching for it, though. It's gonna take way too long. Okay, good thing I keep on shutting down these robots, or otherwise they keep on surprising me. Alright, let's get to Nuka Galaxy. That's where I was heading towards next before I heard all the gunfire. Still gonna take what I can. Here that I might want. Nuka cherries, regular Nuka colas. I'm gonna start mixing drinks just to see what I can make later. But right now, let's focus on the mission. Grabbing as many star cores as I can possibly find. I'm guessing another batch is gonna be inside Nuka Galaxy. Well, at least now that I can start looking around without having to worry about getting shot, I'll take my time. Oh yeah, and there was the portion of the park where Gage was getting hit by all those iBots. I wonder what that was all about. Yeah, it was up here, we were shooting all down here. And here are the iBots, but they're kind of... Yeah, the textures are all warped. And I'm gonna have to figure out why later. Oh, another... Ah, this is the one that blew up, right. Incendiary leather right arm. Well, incendiary certainly right after what I witnessed. Anything else? Anything I missed? Sweet rolls. Not gonna steal sweet rolls! Don't need some guy in a medieval outfit coming to charge at me, telling me that I'm under arrest. Okay, yeah, seeing these robots just suddenly pop up and then go down is kind of disturbing, but hey! Good to know that my shutdown commands are actually working, because otherwise I would have walked right into that turret. And this leads me back to Star Control. I know I haven't explored all the park yet, because I'm obviously missing some star cores that should be obvious. But alright, well, oh, is there anything here? Anything over here? No. No. Got my hopes up, got my hopes up. Ah, peckish from lack of food, I was waiting for that. Okay, let's get that out of the way. We got the usual vegetable soups and noodle cups. Surviving entirely off of what are essentially canned soups. Well, freshly made canned soups. It's a college... Well, college freshman, well, a cheap college freshman's diet. They survived for a year on it. I can too. Alright, let's see what's gonna be in here. Get ready, Porter. We might have to do a bit of warring among the stars. Yeah, that was rather weak too, wasn't it? Yeah, well, I did what I could. I did what I could.